In this video, you'll see how to integrate Fluent Bit into CloudWatch Container Insights for Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or Amazon EKS. With this lightweight solution, you can efficiently stream Amazon EKS logs into CloudWatch logs, reduce your log delivery resource footprint, and track your log stream to prevent bottlenecks and delivery errors. To get started, let's review some information about Fluent Bit, which we'll be using to send logs from an Amazon EKS cluster to CloudWatch logs. Fluent Bit is an open-source and multi-platform log processor and forwarder that allows you to collect data and logs from different sources, and unify and send them to different designations for logs storage and analytics. These statistics demonstrate the performance advantage Fluent Bit has over Fluent D in CPU and memory usages. Let's navigate to Amazon EKS and take a look at the cluster we've set up for the purposes of this example. Let's drill down into the cluster and review its configuration. This cluster has the latest Kubernetes version installed. It also has 3 worker nodes. Next, let's take a quick look at the AWS Cloud9 environment we've set up for the purposes of this example. Before we start setting up Fluent Bit, let's review the documentation. This documentation provides details on how to deploy Fluent Bit to send logs from containers to CloudWatch logs. The first step is to create a namespace. Let's copy the command to do so and paste it into the Cloud9 console. Next, let's return to the setup documentation and copy another command. We'll use this command to create a config map with the cluster name and region to send the logs to. Next, we'll copy the command to download and deploy the Fluent Bit daemon set to the cluster. For our purposes, we'll use the optimized configuration, rather than the one that is more similar to Fluent D. Finally, let's copy and paste the command to validate the Fluent Bit deployment. As you can see, we have 3 Fluent Bit pods running. Let's make sure that events are being sent to CloudWatch logs. We've confirmed that the events are being sent. Let's navigate to CloudWatch. We'll search for our EKS cluster among the log groups. Here are the 3 log groups associated with our cluster. Let's drill down into one of them and check the application logs. Let's expand our view of the log stream column. Now let's search for logs related to the billing app. We can drill down into the individual log streams. Here we can see all the logs running on this billing app. We can drill down further to see even more specifics. Next, let's go over some best practices for creating a successful log delivery pipeline. First, when defining your Fluent Bit image, it's recommended that you use the latest official version of Fluent Bit. Second, always define memory and CPU limits for each Fluent Bit pod. Third, it is recommended to define multiple input streams based on smart logical groupings. Another best practice is to use the Kubernetes filter to enrich the log entries. Let's take a look at the optimized YAML file we implemented earlier. As you can see, we're running Kubernetes filter, which is providing metadata for our logs. It's also recommended to run AWS filter alongside Kubernetes filter, as we are here. Another recommendation is to increase the memory buffer limit of Fluent Bit to 50 megabytes for application logs. Finally, AWS recommends enabling a built-in HTTP server, which makes it easier to monitor metrics. After enabling the HTTP server, you can create dashboards resembling these graphs in CloudWatch logs or Grafana. You've just seen how to integrate Fluent Bit into CloudWatch Container Insights for Amazon EKS. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.